So today we are going to talk about the Arbalest. If you're unaware, this is the new kinetic linear fusion rifle coming from the new event out. This gun is a very, very top-tier exotic to have for any PvE content. It can smash through enemy shields, arc, solar, or void. It's very, very good for doing anything that's going to have you to have match game. This thing is going to just right through its shield. It doesn't matter. It's a very good, you know, exotic perk. Basically, there's no point to having, you know, coordinated singes of solar, void, or arc. If you have this weapon, you already have all three for your primary. Very good weapon. And Gambit, this weapon shines not only the slaying out ads, as you can see, I'm destroying anything shields with a one shot and then a second shot to follow up. This gun synergizes very, very well with Recluse. You break something's shield, kill it, swap to your Recluse, kill any little minions, or you can even smash through something's shield. This loadout is very, very, very good for destroying elemental shields. Very, very good for killing people in Crucible and even invading in Gambit. I'm going to get into that in a second. So, in Gambit, this gun, while invading, is almost like Sleeper Simulant or Queen Breaker's Bow, but it's not as overpowered. This gun acts more like a sniper more than it does a fusion rifle. It's a kinetic rifle. But the reason I think it's so good at multitasking between PvE and PvP is because it's not broken to the point where, you know, Sleeper is where it will one-shot you to the body. This gun is a two-tap to the body, doing 166 damage per body shot, which is pretty solid if you are team-shotting in a competitive match, and you need an easy pick. For people that are not good at sniping, this gun might get you into sniping. The only thing that will throw you off is the charge-up, but the charge-up is not that bad if you are, you know, good at sniping or good at using linear fusion rifles. The charge-up will not throw you off. Matter of fact, I believe it's probably one of the faster charge-up weapons, linear fusion rifles, and it's a very good slay-out in PvE, PvP. A headshot in PvP, it's 414 damage. In other words, you hit someone in the head, they're dead. Killing supers of this weapon, I don't doubt that'll be 1 to 2 shots. Hitting a headshot, you could probably hit him for probably a good 300, if not no more. And a follow-up shot would probably take them out of their super after that. So this gun is well-balanced. It's good in Gambit, good in strikes, good in raids. And it's not overpowered. And I like it where it is right now. It's fairly easy to obtain, you know. Most of you probably have this weapon. If you don't get this weapon, it's okay. After the event, it will be coming in exotic engrams, I believe, and then you just have to have good RNG, which is not too hard, unless you're me and you have horrible RNG, which it hurts sometimes. I'm still trying to get Getaway Artist. Love Getaway Artist. Seeing it in Crucible hurts that I don't have it. But if you don't have this weapon, I would definitely recommend getting this weapon. It is very good. Synergizes with almost any gun, and it's very good if you have a scavenger. It's very good if you have a targeting adjustment on your armor too. This gun is—it's a well-balanced weapon, Crucible, and any other content you want to run. There's no reason to take this weapon off, at all. And having these perks on your armor synergizes very, very well on this weapon. Targeting and scavenger are basically a necessity for this weapon because you're not going to have, you know, a lot of chances where you get, you know, ammo. You're going to want to kill someone in the crucible, run over, get that 2 to 3 shots, back off. You're not going to want to go bang, 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 you know, go get one bullet at a time. You're going to want to, you know, kill one person, get 2 shots, kill another person, get 2 shots, have a little bit of ammo, right? The targeting adjuster on your armor, very good too. This weapon flinches like a sniper rifle, even though it's not a sniper rifle. So you're going to want this targeting adjuster. Even when being flinched, this targeting adjuster will give you a little bit of that edge of snapping back to their heads, and that splits 1 to 2 seconds that they are, you know, not hitting you or reloading or, you know, just missing their shots. Maybe you're a better shot than them. They're missing a few shots from far away. You have that second to get off that perk. I mean, that shot. So, that's all I have to say on this weapon. Enjoy the rest of the gameplay. I will see you guys in the next video. If you like videos like this, reviewing weapons, me giving tips on, you know, what synergizes really well with a weapon, or, you know, how to set up your loadout, help me out in the comments. Drop a like on it, subscribe, ring that bell, and I will catch you guys in the next video. Stay cool. Yeah, I don't know how to end this, so I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a nice weekend.